Plant breeding is genetic diversity. It's as simple as that. It's the basis of our food. The world changes. The climate changes. Consumer demand changes. Agriculture changes. And the only way to adapt our crops to those new environments is by plant breeding.
Biodiversity is really important for us. For what we do to produce products for the farmers, it's something we absolutely need. There are going to be other breeders in the future after us, and we need to make sure we maintain biodiversity. If we lose biodiversity, we will have problems in the future which we won't be able to overcome because we won't have the resource to do it.
The breeder is only as good as the diversity he has in his breeding program. If he has no diversity, he can't make any selections. So he needs to bring in new diversity all the time, and we've seen a huge change in, for example, the rust populations across Europe, with strains coming in from Asia, which have completely wiped out the old races of yellow rust, for example. So we can't sit back and assume that everything's going to be all right. We need to keep looking for new sources of resistance.
We distribute thousands of samples every year. The breeders don't request that for fun. They look for traits, they look for disease resistances, they look for drought tolerance, they look for all kinds of new traits that will enrich the varieties that are grown by the farmers now. If we compare the modern varieties of now with those of 50, 100 years ago, it's an exponential improvement of yield, of quality, of all those things that we appreciate.
As a breeder, I'm very happy to help to develop new varieties that are very interesting for our consumers, that have other shapes, have a better taste, that we can grow without chemical residues. Biodiversity is extremely important for us because it's the only way that we can find new traits. I believe that we really need this kind of variation to come to varieties that are better than what we had before.
In fact, it's unfortunate that we see that many governments in the public sector are neglecting the importance of biodiversity and say that it's the interest of the private sector. That is partly true. Private sector has an interest, has also the need to invest in biodiversity. But there's also a particular role for the public sector to maintain the capacity, to maintain gene banks, to maintain, in fact, also the collaboration between public sector financed institutes and by the private sector institutes.
We have to think a long term in the future. Breeding is not something you do in a year. So we're looking at what is going to be required in the marketplace in 10 plus years' time. We need to protect the diversity that's there so that it can be used in the future. It's like leaving a legacy that's valuable for the future, where the challenges may be well different from what we've got now. It's important to make sure that we've got something we can use for that.